Steve in our army painting department has shown me a really cool technique that he used to paint the noble heraldry on the House Terryn Imperial Knights that he painted. This is to get that ivory and black pattern that they have. And I thought it'd be really cool to show you how he went about doing it, because, well, it looks great. To do it, first of all, what you need is a base coat of Xandri dust, and then we layer over this area using a shabty bone. Then we dry brush it with Screaming Skull in quite an unusual way, and then redefine the edges using Seraphim Sepia. After that, we paint in the actual heraldry itself, and for that we use a Abaddon Black. So starting then with Xandri dust, I'm going to use a medium base brush for this, and I do have an Imperial Knight shoulder plate that I've prepared up to the point where you would start painting this pattern in. And so what you need to do is get your paint ready, nice and smooth, a bit of water mixed in there, and then it's just a matter of base coating this onto this area of the armour. And as usual, I'm going to be applying two thin coats to build it up to a good strong colour before we move on to the next stage. Then apply an all-over layer of a shabty bone onto the panel. Now, I'm still using my medium base brush to apply this because it's a good size for this area, but definitely apply this as two thin coats once again to avoid getting any brush marks appearing on the panel. Now we're ready to dry brush the panel using Screaming Skull. The technique here is quite unusual because what I'm looking to do is do circular motions like this to gradually build up the colour, so I'm almost buffing it really. Now you don't go all the way to the edge, just focusing towards the middle like this, but just take your time building up the colour gradually. And there we are. Now the Screaming Skull is subtle, but it gives a really nice ivory appearance. And what we need to do now is apply a recessed shade all around the edges using Seraphim Sepia. And there we are, that's the ivory part done. Now the next thing to do is to paint the actual heraldry onto it. And you could use a black transfer for this, or you can use a Abaddon Black to paint a design. And what you should do is orientate the panel so that that part down there is horizontal, and then base the pattern around that. And I'm going to go for a chevron, so starting with a black line roughly in the middle, about there. I'm just going to apply this on as a guide point, then gradually widen the line out and repeat this process on the opposite side. And there we are, I've painted in the chevron, and well, there we go. Now you could of course do something more complicated if you want to, but that's entirely up to you. But well, I hope you found this useful and interesting, seeing that alternate way of dry brushing where you buff it rather than go for the edges. And of course you can do this with all sorts of different colours. So I hope you have fun using it, and we'll see you again very soon.